Good afternoon. I'm Reverend V.J. Stover. I'm the interim pastor here at West Street Christian Church. Thanks for being here today to honor and to give thanks and to celebrate the life of Linda. I am the stranger among you. You know the stories, and I don't. And yet I am in the role of telling you there are stories. So thank you, first of all, for honoring me with this to celebrate Linda's life. And thank you also for bearing with me as I am bearing with you. For we are here to feel the joy of each other's laughter in this story, and we are to taste the salt of each other's tears. And I know that this is what you will do. Shall we pray? Lord our God, in this, the darkest part of our year, we are here to remember the light and life that has been with us many years. And to come to understand through your guidance and care that this light continues to shine on our path. So help us this day to remember, perhaps as we have never remembered before, and perhaps as if we are not to forget, a life well lived and loved that we knew as Linda. Come, celebrate with us, O Lord. In the name of the Christ we pray. Amen. Have some scriptures to start with. I'll start with the longest one. It's one that I often come across that needs to be read because it reminds us that even in biblical times there are people who were just held up and celebrated. This comes at the end of the book of Proverbs. It describes a capable wife. Now, let's not disparage the word capable here. I had a music professor in college that if you did the best job anybody ever heard in the world, he would just say that was pretty capable. So to tell this scripture about Linda and say that she's a capable wife is to say much. A capable wife, who can find? She's more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her. And he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant, and she brings her food from far away. She rises while it is still early and provides food for her household and tasks for those around her. She considers a field and buys it, or as I've seen in the picture, at least discs it. With the fruit of her hand, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. She puts her hands to the distaff and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hand to the poor. She reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid for her household when it snows, for all her household have warm clothing. She makes herself coverings and her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the city gates, taking his seat among the elders of the land. She She makes linen garments and sells them. She supplies the merchant with sashes. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy. Her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all, he says. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share in the fruit of her hands and let her works praise her in the city gates. From the Gospel of Luke, we hear an answer of Christ through the Sadducees, who did not believe in the resurrection, and he showed them by his argument that there was. Indeed, they cannot die anymore because they are like angels and are children of God, being children of the resurrection. And the fact that the dead are raised, Moses himself showed in the story about the bush, where he speaks of the Lord as the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. Now he is God not of the dead, but of the living, for to him all are alive. To repeat that in a different way, now, the Lord as the God of Sarah, of Rebecca, of Rachel, and Linda. Now, he is God not of the dead, but of the living, for to him all are alive. And lastly, part of Paul's definition of love as he saw God as being a God of love. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way, it's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoings, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. And lastly, a poem that we probably have heard that was a favorite of Linda's. One night a man had a dream. He dreamed he was walking along the beach with the Lord, and across the sky flashed scenes from his life. And for each scene he noticed two sets of footprints in the sand, one belonging to him and the other to the Lord. When the last scene of his life flashed before him, he looked back at the footprints in the sand, and he noticed that many times along the path of his life, there was only one set of footprints. He also noticed that it happened at the very lowest and saddest times in his life. This really bothered him, and he questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I've noticed that during the most troublesome times in my life, there is only one set of footprints. I don't understand why. When I needed you most, you would leave me. And the Lord replied, my son, my precious child, I love you. And I would never leave you. And during your times of trial and suffering, when you see only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you. And that is the original version of the poem as set forth by Carolyn Carty in 1963. At this time, we have some music offered by some of the family. While driving over here from my home in Lebanon this morning, I happened to listen to one of my favorite radio programs. What it is not the program itself is not important, but they presented a piece of music, and the title of that music was Whispered Memories. And that just stuck to me. Not like chewing gum to a shoe, but like a good meal sticks with you. Whispered Memories. Today is a day where all our memories are put into a basket and it somehow gets upset. And we're all here collecting memories and telling stories and trying to make sense of Linda's life so that somehow our life makes sense again. Because it's in that upsettedness where all those memories get spilled out, and as we start putting them back in, we don't put them back in the same order. And when they're not in the same order, then somehow we're not the same person, and that's okay. Because to understand that, to accept that, means that Linda has done her work in our lives. For you see, her illness was the one that took memories away while she was with us. But now she can reclaim all those memories with God. And she's making sense of those memories all over again and loving each one, savoring each one for the taste that it is. Now, we who are here understand that our memories are helping us love Linda in a new way. You know, and when I talked about love, it hasn't changed any of those things, that new way. For you see, what we are struggling with is still trying to be the best person we can be because we loved Linda. You're not here because you love me. You're here because you love Linda. And you want to be still that person that Linda encouraged you to be without saying, you can do it better than that. She just did her encouragement because you wanted to be a better person because of Linda. And you're that way for a lot of people in your life because that's the nature of love. When you love someone, it brings out the best in you. For that's the nature of love. Very often when a couple comes to me and talks about, oh, we want to get married. I just can't live without this person. I remind them, well, you lived without them before you met them. Or, I can't imagine my life without them. Well, you did have a life before them. One of my least favorite movies is the movie that says, You Complete Me. Well, you were a complete person before Linda. All that Linda did was encourage you in her way of loving you that said, I want to be the best for you. And the same way with children and grandchildren, with nephews and nieces and cousins and friends. Think about how Linda shared her life in loving others. You know, volunteering, working at church in the nursery, disking a field. I don't know how often she did that, but at least once. And from what I could see, unless it was a staged picture, her lines of disc were much straighter than I would have ever done. But now we're also faced with all those individual memories coming back into that basket in a new way, so that we can make sense of Linda's life and of our life, and being challenged by the fact that we can't love Linda the way we used to. Can't mail her a Christmas card, call her on the phone, visit her. All those old expressions passed away. And most of those passed away before Linda died. And now, in these last few months, you learned the lesson of the lessons, because there's more than one, of learning Linda, loving Linda in new ways that you never thought that you would have to do. So the gift of the disease was to put you into a process that now is enriched in you so that you can learn the new ways of loving Linda. There's just too many L's in that sentence. Learning to love Linda in new ways because you have to. Because, yeah. Death says it's final. Love says it's not. So now, every one of you, myself included, will be learning in the days ahead how to remember and to love and to be that better person in new ways. And that's because she encouraged you in the way you should go. Sometimes that meant letting you be. Sometimes that meant running interference. Sometimes that meant the discipline of life, saying you're doing it wrong. Sometimes that meant the discipline of life by saying, you know, that was a pretty good job. Keep doing it. And I'm sure every one of you heard the phrase, just keep plugging away. Something like that. See, God imparts God's love to us through the people around us. And it was Linda's job to pass that wisdom on when it's hard, just keep plugging. Now, that memory is with us. And it cannot be forgotten. And it is ours to pass on. For surely that just didn't start with Linda. It came to her from other folk. It just happens to be by accident that my last name is the same as her maiden name. Far as I know, I'm not related. And I wish I were. Can I be adopted?
Sure.
Because there are times in my life, even now, when I would love to hear someone just say, just keep plugging away. And now I can. Because I have today with you all. I think of her life as she kept on plugging away at things. Things that would defeat other people. But she just kept plugging away, understanding that you don't have to do it forever, just today. God takes care of forever. Our job is just today. And today, our sole job is to be the best person that Linda loved. This is the woman that the Proverbs writer writes about, a capable woman. This is the woman that passed on faith so that resurrection is the reality. This is the woman who taught us that love never ends. So, my peace I give you, not as the world would give, but as the love of Linda would give. Shall we pray one more time? Lord our God, here we stand together at the edge of eternity, and Linda's at the gate stepping through, and we can't go with her. Help us to stay. Help us to love. Help us to plug away. Help us to just keep plugging. Lord, may you remember us as we would remember Linda. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. We have one final song.
Well, Lord our God, here we are again in your presence, being held in the palm of your hand. Thank you for this rest, for even the most courageous and wise of people must have rest. O Lord our God, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection which is ours through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend our sister into your loving care and commit her body to the ground as earth to earth, ash to ash, and dust to dust. In the peace of eternity, Lord, may she and us all reside in the safety and security of the palms of your hand, now and forever. May you, O Lord, remember us as we would remember her. And in the name of the risen Christ, we pray. Amen.